Okay, posture two. We're still talking about grace and truth, but what you're going to do today and what you've done this past week is you have studied how Jesus practiced grace and truth. Now, the reality is, if you've never played soccer and you go out to practice with someone who plays soccer every day, you're not going to be as good as them. No harm, no foul, right? It's not about how good you are. It's about how willing you are to practice, right? Anything worth doing is worth doing poorly at first. And so Jesus, he is the master of grace and truth. So we're learning from the best of the best. He knows how to do this in every situation. Why? Because he is directly connected to the Father, and he stands always consistently in a posture of grace and truth. He never allowed his circumstances to pull or push him into a place other than grace and truth. And so we can study him, and by studying him, we learn from him how to be like him in the world around us. And so the idea would be, if you've not done this, you're not going to be good at it. And so the expectation that you have to figure this out, like, is just not necessary. Like, you're learning. We're learning how to walk in grace and truth. We've never experienced today before. Today is today. I've never experienced today. I've practiced grace and truth in lots of situations, never in today's situations. And so today I get the opportunity to practice grace and truth. And one of the ways I do that best is by studying how Jesus did it. And so as you dive into this week, here's what I want you to look at. I want you to look at the way that Jesus was present with people. How was he connecting to them? How was he meeting them where they were at? How did he show value to them? How did you find love? Where's love in the situation? Where is him being real with people? But then also, I want you to look at, like, where's the truth? How is he the true north? How is he calling people up into being who he's created them to be? Where do you see truth and where do you see grace? And study how those sort of go hand in hand. Jesus, because of his grace, Jesus was able to speak bold truth. Because of his truth, Jesus was able to be fully present with people right where they were, right? And so they worked hand in hand together. And so what I want you to do today, simply walk through those scenarios with your group and have a conversation. What made sense? What didn't make sense? What feels really challenging? What do I hear God saying in regards to me and my learning to practice grace and truth with those around me? Okay, that's it. Just have a conversation about how you see Jesus, the master teacher, teaching you today about grace and truth.